वेलकम जी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस वन डिजाइन पैटर्न नेम एज ए एग्जीक्यूटर अराउंड मेथड डिजाइन पैटर्न। आई एम गोइंग टू इंप्लीमेंट दिस डिजाइन पैटर्न यूजिंग द लैम्ब्डा एक्सप्रेशंस। ओके, फर्स्ट वी ट्राई टू अंडरस्टूड की व्हाट द मीनिंग ऑफ एग्जीक्यूटर अराउंड डिजाइन पैटर्न। एग्जीक्यूटर अराउंड डिजाइन पैटर्न से कि लेट्स की दिस इज माय वन मेथड। इफ दिस मेथड इज कंप्लीटेड आफ्टर दैट आई वांट टू डू समथिंग एंड बिफोर दैट इट इफ नीड वी कैन डू समथिंग। कस्टमर यूज ओनली दिस मेथड, लेट्स की मेथड एम वन, एंड बिफोर this method I want to perform something and after completion of this method I want to perform something. Similar name execute around as around this method design patterns. Okay, design pattern. So here I am going to take a simple example, like generally we have some resources, maybe external resources, file system, database connection, something. Generally whenever we have to open the database connection and perform some operations, and then we have to close the connections, close the file system, open file system, close file system, between that we have to perform like read operation, write operation, anything we need to. So generally for that for doing any cleanup activities, generally multiple Java developer are doing some like all the cleanup operation, all the file close operation generally do in your finalize method. But since Java 9, these finalize methods are deprecated. So what would be the best way? The best way this design pattern say you can use this patterns to implement a lambda expression. Help, we can implement this design pattern easy way. Sometime we are using the finalize, okay, to clean up all the resources, but this finalize methods are deprecated as 9. After that, some developer might be use your ARM, automatic resource management tools, try with resources, and in the finally block we are performing a cleanup operation. But sometime developer manually we have to manually this code. Sometime maybe someone forget to invoke the cleanup operations, close operations, your file, your database connection is still open. So for those scenario and situation, whenever the particular business method is executed by your invoked by the client, and whenever this method is completed, operations 1, operation 2, and before I want to do something and after that I want to do some cleanup file. So this our system automatically do, instead don't, if developer forget to do cleanup, it's still our code can achieve that. So let's see how I am going to write. I'm not going to write any open file system here doing a database connection. This is just writing on dummy resource class. Class resource. Let's see resource have some operation on operation to method, like public, let's say resource operation 1. Let's key return this, and here my writer op one is called. Okay, similarly let's key have another operation like operator 2. Let's key we have a public one क्लीन अप ऑपरेशन वाइड क्लीन अप हियर क्लीन ऑल एक्सटर्नल रिसोर्सेस ठीक है ना क्लीन ऑल द एक्सटर्नल रिसोर्सेस ओके लेट्स की दिस इज द मेथड इफ यू आर गोइंग टू यूज लाइक रिसोर्सेस इक्वल टू न्यू रिसोर्सेस ओके एंड आफ्टर दैट यू हैव योर रिसोर्सेस डॉट ऑपरेशन मे बी वन यू हैव टू यूज यू हैव टू रिसोर्सेस ऑपरेशन टू यूज ओके एंड इन जनरल रिसोर्सेज ऑपरेशन क्लीन अप तो जनरली दिस इज द सीक्वेंस ईच डेवलपर मस्ट फॉलो बट might be someone don't know we have to use cleanup operation or not what happen if this line throw exception or what happen this line throw exception this may be cleanup is not performed then so how you ensure that ki anyhow if anything happen still this cleanup operation should be performed okay so how you do it For those this execute around method say if we client only use this operation one operation two if someone forget to do it instead of exposing this why our code why our resources cannot do automatic so for the those purpose instead of allowing to create a new object and invoke the function manually instead we are exposing like just I'm going to create one private constructor private constructor so that no one any can construct it and after that I am going to expose one public static method that return resources just like use and here I am they return void void and here I am perform like a resource or resources sources equal to new resources and we perform like a resources dot cleanup okay so that ki if let's ki now we don't use this if I am going to resources dot use if I use this clean up operation perform but question is that how will perform invoke method 1 method 2 I want to invoke all two so for that I am going to use the lambda expression I am going to use the one functional interface consumer type resources like the block of code and here I am going to use the drive block and your block dot accept your resources and after that catch maybe in exceptions I pop on after that finally I want to resource cleanup So this is the way. Now here resources take resources, and here we can pass resources dot op operation 1 might be you want to operation 2 dot operation 2 as well as. So here you just use operation resources dot operation 1 operation 2 and don't need to clean up might we have to perform any. If you run it, you notice here operation 1 invoke, operation 2 invoke, but clean up all the resources also invoked. So here we need to understand how the simple way of using, we are using the resources or class, use the use methods, and here with the help of resources I want to perform operation 1, operation 2. Here you notice that client does not create any new object. Client just know this is the resources class, I want to invoke operation 1 and operation 2. If someone forget to invoke cleanup operation, still this execute around pattern, this way we can automatic invoke. If those, the logic is here all operation 1 and operation 2 are executed, and before that I want to do something, I can do. After the execution of those operation, I want to do something, I want to do. So here I want to perform cleanup, maybe here I want to perform some initialization, you can do here. Okay, here I'm going to explain how this code look like work. If you notice, this resources.use function taken a consumer functional interface. This is the functional interface. We have one accept method T. So if anyone can invoke this use function, they have to pass the object of this consumer interface. From Java 8 onward, we have two options. We can pass object of an layer. Okay, if you notice here I am using this use function, here we have to pass the object of consumer interface. So notice, what is this? This is the object of control. No, this is your definition of your consumer interface. We are passing the body, implementation body of a consumer interface here. This is the input, this is the input, and this is your output. So if you look here, they need a consumer interface, so we have to implement the implementation class here and provide the one method definition of accept T, pass a T argument and return some value. So here the implementation, here is the implementation. This is the implementation of a consumer interface. If you want to manually do, if you write here consumer interface type resources, let's key R resource consumer equal to new consumer resource interface, or here you have to resource object pass resource dot op1, pass resource dot up to, okay, and instead of calling this, you can pass here complete resource consumer object. This is also the way we can do. Okay, similar function, but do you notice that out putrescindral. But here, instead of pass, here we, what happened here, we are creating in the class, overriding the accept method, giving the definition what I want, and after that we are creating the object, and this object reference we are going to pass here. So instead of doing this, we, you can directly use lambda expression instead of creating object. What is what lambda expression say? These are unnecessary things. You don't need. Your logic should be like this. This is your important part which you want. This is the only part you want. This is the same thing written here. Your resource is your input parameter. The resource is your input parameter. After this input parameter, what you want? Invoke operation 1, invoke operation 2. From resources dot invoke operation 1 and operation 2. So lambda expression concise your code. Actually, what you want really, that is the needed portion is need to write by developer. Rest all the thing, all the blue extra code, unnecessary code is taken care by your compiler and JVM. Don't bother. So here we are using the important thing, invoke operation 1, invoke operation 2 with on the input parameter this. So here we are using the input parameter and operation 1 and operation 2. So instead of writing your normal class, anonymous class or interface implementation class, instead we can write your lambda expression. Here you notice now you can understand. Here use function take a consumer object. So we have given a consumer object. Okay, and a consumer object have a one method accept. Here accept is invoked. Okay. Here accept is invoke. The definition, implementation, logic written here. The same logic written here. This is your logic of your implementation, logic of your accept method. The same, whenever this method invoke, at that time, this logic is executed. Whenever this two is completed, after try catch, we are finally do our cleanup operations. Okay, so the lambda expressions make developer life so easy to write the code is more concise and what really needed code, not unnecessary code. Here only needed we have one input operation and perform operation 1 and operation 2. Don't need to write all the step. Don't need to write the complete class and create the object. Instead of creating a class, creating object and passing the object here, instead you can just pass the what the business logic. Our business logic on the basis of request input, I want to invoke operation 1 and operation 2. Here your input operation and I want to perform operation 1 and operation 2. This is what is only needed. So lambda enforce, developer use the things that really needed. Don't do other things that can be done by your compiler and JVM. So this way we can here we can implement it or execute around method design patterns. What do we have? This is your business logic. Okay, before that I want to do something, after that I want to do something. So that is done. Here what we actually did, here this is your invocation of operation 1 and operation 2. Before that I can create the object, after that I was a cleanup operation. This is the execute align pattern, and that can easily implemented using the functional interface with the help of lambda expression. Lambda expression help you to write code concise and really needed code. That is the now needed. So hope this examples demonstrate and clear your concept how we can use your lambda expression while implementing your design patterns. Whenever you are implementing any design pattern, you will try to will think its place where we can replace the normal class, implement a particular interface and anonymous class interface or interface implementation, creating the class, creating a class, creating the object and thus passing the object to a particular function. Instead, we can directly pass the particular function definition. Complete function code here, not passing object. Instead, we are passing the complete business logics. What really needed? So any function before Java, it generally have a Java compiler enforce you ki any method you can pass anything, each and everything in the form of object. Object is the first class citizen. You can pass to a particular method, pass to a particular any input for message communication. But from Java 8 onward, now we have options. We can pass Java object to the method, or you can pass the complete business logic, your method definition inside a method. Any method, any function, take input as another function. Every function, that is the such function known as a higher order function. The higher order functions help to implement using the lambda expression. The lambda expression is useful to writing higher order function, and higher order function help to reduce your unnecessary code that didn't need it. Hope it's useful. If you want to play with this code, I'll just upload it my blog. You can check out my blog and take this code and play with around and try to understood ki how lambda expressions are going to use while developing, while implementing any design patterns and principle. Thank you.